Setting up a media server. With ever-growing collections of music, movies, photos and other media files taking up space on our computers, there are little many of us looking to move those collections to an external location like a media server, in order to save space on our hard disks and have our entire collections accessible to all users at all times. To achieve this, you could buy a new NAS, network-attached storage, or a dedicated unit, like a Drobo. But, why not consider refurbishing your old computer as your brand new media server? For instance, if you're lucky enough to have an old desktop computer tower with up to 4 SATA hard disks, plus extra RAM, if needed, and turned into a powerhouse server. Indeed, with a little help from Disk Utility, you could turn those extra hard disks into a RAID system, using level 1 RAID mirroring to ensure maximum reliability, even though this will mean your two extra drives, identical in terms of make, model and capacity, and will become one effective system with half the disk's total capacity available because of the data mirroring. Now we're getting down to the exciting part, configuring your Mac as an iTunes server. With this method, you'll be able to share your iTunes media with not only the other Macs on your network, but the iOS devices as well, so long as they're all connected to the same router. 1. Transfer your music. The simplest way to transfer your iTunes library to your new media server is to use Migration Assistant in Applications, Utilities. And both computers need to be on the same network, connected to the same router. Run Migration Assistant as normal, but drill down to your music folder and transfer only that. 2. Set up your server. Remember, both computers need to be on the same network. If you're going to leave your iTunes server running all the time, go to System Preferences, Energy Saver, and make sure the computer sleep slider is set to Never, and check the checkboxes on Wake for Network Access and Start up automatically after a power failure. The checkbox Put hard disks to sleep when possible should remain empty, and set the display sleep slider to any sensible value to suit. 3. Get your server running. In iTunes, go to File, Home Sharing, turn on Home Sharing. The main iTunes pane will then turn into a login window, which then you need to enter your Apple ID and password before clicking on Turn on Home Sharing. You'll need to enable Home Sharing on all the Macs on your network that are running iTunes 9 or later, entering the same Apple ID and password on each. Setting up a file server. It's not only music you can share across your network. Having the files you and other family members need to access regularly in a central location can help to avoid confusion. Remember, however, to back them up regularly, either with Time Machine or with a disk cloning utility. 1. Prepare your server. Go to System Preferences, Energy Saver on your server, and follow the second step of our iTunes server tutorial. We'd also suggest using System Preferences, Network, to set a static IP address by changing the IPv4 configuration to be using a DHCP with manual address. To do this, you'll need to find out about your router IP address settings, which is outside the scope of this tutorial. If you're not sure how to do this, you can watch this videos, where you can learn something about networking. 2. Enable file sharing. On every Mac you want to share files from, including your new server, go to System Preferences, Sharing, and tick the boxes next to File Sharing and Screen Sharing. 3. Accessing your server. To access your server, open a Finder window and look for the name of your server in the sidebar. Click on it, and you'll be given the choice either to connect as a user or share screen. Click your choice. Then enter an admin username and password. This should be an admin user, registered on the server, not on your Mac. Once you're in, you can navigate the server's contents as your own Mac. You can watch a similar procedure in this video, setting up a network-attached storage.